unity. That's the message as the Pacific Islands Forum opened in Fiji today, the first face-to-face meeting in 3 years. Climate change, security and a COVID rebound also high on the agenda, as was the Micronesian nation of Kiribati, which has withdrawn from the forum entirely.
Diplomacy in paradise. A ceremonial welcome to Fiji for the Pacific Islands Forum. Uniting 16 leaders.
This is no ordinary forum.
Foreign Minister Penny Wong keeping the Prime Minister's seat warm until he arrives tomorrow.
We are here to listen and learn. It's obviously my first forum. There's actually a sense of relief that finally Australia is prepared to actually do something.
Discussing how to navigate the biggest threat to the Pacific.
Will we forge ahead together? Will we take individual paths?
Climate change at the forefront.
It's the number one national security, economic challenge that the region faces.
Pacific Island countries have been telling the world for decades that climate change is a threat akin to war, so it's like being bombed.
The leaders last met in 2019, and since then, Australia's got a new government with higher emissions reductions targets, and the Solomon Islands has signed a security pact with China.
The four-day summit here in Suva is taking place at a time of intense geostrategic competition, and regional solidarity is paramount.
But a chair is empty. Kiribati withdrawing over a leadership dispute perceived as Beijing's influence.
And I say, along with all other members of the forum, that we seek reconciliation and the door remains open.
China's request to participate at PIF was knocked back.
The membership of the PIF is clear in Australia, and others are members of the PIF, others are not.
And yet it's been confirmed US Vice President Kamala Harris will dial in to tomorrow's leaders' meeting, a huge Pacific power play. Chloe Bouris for 10 News First, Suva.